think me not being a Juventus fan, I just wanted the Juventus to win so badly because I wanted I want Inter to be you know put almost with one foot on the grave and one on a banana sleep. But it didn't happen. How the hell are you guys cannot capitalize on a game like this?
This was the game that, again, I haven't changed my stance since the beginning. You know, this morning when Inter tied Cagliari, I got a text from Mike. Oh, you see, this is how the Scudetto goes. But I don't believe in that. And I think that this today reinforced even more why I believe Inter are going to win the Scudetto. Even when they tie to Cagliari, Juventus, they just don't have that mentality. Sarri said it himself, that they lack the hunger inside the league. I think it was very clear by the way Juventus went out there. There was zero hunger to win that match. Yeah. I think they started playing in the 90th minute when they had maybe their first shot on target. And I think that Inter's got more of a desperation, and now they're reinforcing with Eriksen, with a lot of good players. And I just think I'm very disappointed in the way Juve played. Having said that, Napoli was much better. I think overall, they were playing their hearts out. They knew that there's a couple games that can change your season around. I think even Ludo said it last week, and they won. Who did they beat this week, this past week?
Lazio. They beat Lazio in Coppa Italia.
Exactly. And yeah. I think we said, once you get one game that could kind of go your way, it could kind of be the kickstart to getting out of that rut. And I think that the Lazio and now this Juventus is really good. And credit to Gattuso. I say Gattuso outcoached Sarri tonight.
Yeah. Can I just add something?
By far.
But guys, jump in if you agree with me. Juve were unconvincing today, but I feel like it's nothing new. A lot of these games, even the ones they won, they were unconvincing wins. Their performances didn't show a lot. So even if they lost today, it was another...
They usually get the result.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. And they lost. The only difference is the result.
Exactly.
If it was like a win or they slipped, they got another goal or two, we've been like, oh, another unconvincing win, but Juve got the points.
Yeah, but...
So it's not that much of a surprise other than the result in terms of performance.
Well, yeah, but we're talking about the result.
Yeah, but that's what I'm saying. I feel like it's a huge shock out of nowhere.
I understand what you're saying. But I think Juventus, usually in the past, when teams slip up,
they make sure that they get the
goals. So like the last time Inter slipped up, they scored two goals in 7 minutes versus Roma, and they put the game to sleep.
Gap, right?
Instead, this game, I think, like Marco said, Juventus, Napoli, they don't have any hopes right now. You know, whether it's Europa League, Champions League, if it happens, great. If not, you know, this is the most important game that they'll probably play the whole season. Napoli, Juve, for Napoli fans, Juventus is the biggest, you know.
Especially with Sarri, with Higuain.
Team that you have to win, Sarri, Higuain, all that stuff. So I think the fans and the whole city really felt this game.
For sure.
And, you know, Napoli,
they played like it.
And I think we also have to give credit, like you said, to Gattuso. Because last week we were all saying, why Gattuso? Gattuso still doesn't have control of this team. Mm-hmm. Somehow, some way, he was able to manage. So a question here is, were we a little too hard on Gattuso? Because considering what happened and what transpired with Napoli's season, you know, it's not going to take a couple of games to get that shock. So we just saw versus Lazio, versus Juventus, which are two of the top teams in Serie A, he's actually beat them. Napoli have the quality players. They did make some investments, Lobotka and
Demme.
So Napoli looks like it's a team that maybe not necessarily go up, but can challenge. Potential.
People judge too quickly.
I agree with you. Those few rare times that we agree with each other. But to me, the game, it's on Sarri. Sarri is like he's coaching for Napoli. In other words, he takes the best player on Juventus out. He takes Dybala and he puts...
Bernardeschi.
You got to be kidding me.
How's that coach in Napoli?
Let him say. Let him speak.
Meaning that...
Keep going.
It was the wrong thing to do. It was the wrong thing to do. It's like you are penalizing Juventus by taking your best player out and you are just, you know, you favoring Napoli. So that was the first mistake. Then when Douglas Costa was put in, I think it was put right too closer to the center of the field. Douglas Costa normally plays on the right side and he makes the run that Bernardeschi used to make. I never seen Douglas Costa 20 minutes games today making one cross from the right hand side. Douglas Costa was playing on the middle. I don't understand what did he tell him before he got into the game.
I think that, you know, Dybala wasn't having a good game, but I think that anyone who says that Higuain was having a good game is lying to themselves, because this guy Higuain has been off all season, despite maybe one or two rare occasions where he's shown up. And I think that this game needed Douglas Costa. I think that at halftime, Douglas Costa... I think Matuidi is never in the game. Matuidi plays for the other team every time he plays. I mean, he passed the ball to Napoli on the first goal. The first goal started from a Matuidi on the left side.
He crossed the ball from the, almost the corner to outside the area.
I swear to God, Michael would have made a better cross than that.
Oh,
with your left foot. With your left foot.
I appreciate it.
It was embarrassing.
Just did the challenge.
Did you see again Sarri
taking notes?
What he was taking notes on the offside. Because Higuain went on an offside and then he was writing something. So he's probably going to explain the offside to Higuain.
Make sure you don't.
So when he goes back home, Higuain is going to get a letter from Sarri. You were on offside, technically.
But
is that right?
His obsession with Higuain just baffles me at times. I mean, I understand. I think Higuain's good off the bench, you know, as bench player. But Dybala, in my opinion, this game was begging for Dybala, Ronaldo, and Costa at halftime. I think those three players, your three most important, your three most talented, the three best players of the season, in my opinion, at least up top, needed to be in. And then with Matuidi and a couple of decisions, Pjanic went out and all this kind of stuff. But overall, I agree with you, Antonio. I think that that Sarri was really at fault. Gattuso outcoached him. They came out. He got his team much more motivated than Sarri can. Yeah. Sarri said on multiple occasions that Juve's mentality has been raw. He said we don't have that same mentality to keep winning.
But it starts with the coach. That's him.
I agree, because Juventus over the years would never lose a game like this in the manner that they did.
Oh, right.
And I think that's the difference. But not taking anything away from Napoli.
Maybe the slip up of both Inter and Lazio, kind of because I guess Sarri doesn't give that sense of urgency. Help them to...
Exactly.
He's not, no. It's not
that's what I'm saying. The slip...
That guy's if not Inter, a Juventus caliber.
He's agreeing.
I'm saying
he's agreeing
if
with
Inter
you.
Wins, maybe Juventus wins this game.
Exactly. I completely agree with that. I completely agree with that.
For some reasons, I think that Marotta is working the phone.
No, Anto.
I don't know.
You have crazy conspiracy theories.
By the way, wait, real quick. We made you an Instagram account. You have your own Instagram account.
I don't have Instagram.
Specifically for you.
We're running it. It's at IFTV Antonio. People are loving it. I think you have like 700, 800 followers. Where we're just posting the stuff that you send us.
It's his best moments of you being a genius.
Because everybody's is going crazy for it. So you got your own page because everybody needed
it. Which means that whatever I say goes.
Whatever you send there.
Guys, when I'm right, I'm right. Even when I'm wrong, I'm right.